Bubblegum Digest with Allyson Johnson, H.L. Sillitz, and the Bubblegum Digest team. And now, here's Allyson.
It was decision day in Illinois for selecting a candidate for governor, as well as other state officials, on both the Democratic and Republican sides. On March 16th, Illinois held its primary race, and it was exciting. The Democrats had to choose between our present governor, Dan Walker, and his challenger, Michael J. Howlett. The Republicans had to choose between former federal prosecutor James Thompson and Winnetka businessman Richard Cooper. Early in the races, the voters waited anxiously to see who would win. Finally, Michael Howlett and Republican James Thompson were declared the winners.
Also this week, the Illinois presidential primaries took place throughout the state. President Gerald Ford beat Ronald Reagan on the Republican side, and Jimmy Carter pulled ahead and beat George Wallace and the other candidates on their Democratic front. The primaries are mini elections in which the people decide who will run for the President of the United States. There will be more primaries coming up through June. After that, the two parties, Democrats and Republicans, will have conventions to decide who the final candidates will be for the presidential election in November. Allyson?
Another problem with school integration took place this week in Oak Park. The Oak Park School Board has approved a desegregation plan which would turn two elementary schools into junior high schools. However, a group of Oak Park citizens called Citizens for Neighborhood Schools is against the plan but denies that they are against racial integration. A group member, Mrs. Sandra Wazalewski, said that the Oak Park residents have always been against junior high schools. They prefer the neighborhood school concept. The kids go from kindergarten to eighth grade at the same school. HL?